Hi, I'm Dr. Varudhini Kankipati, and welcome to Mann Ghatt. Today we're going to spend some time and talk about quality time. Time is something we all are scrambling to find, and there's so much we want to do and accomplish, and so we're limited in the amount of time we have. One of the things that I have always noticed is we somehow do not understand where to divide time. So we have time that we have to give to work, but the other area is relationships. And there are three predominant areas of relationships that we need to spend some time with. The first one is the relationship and how much time you're giving to yourself, individual. The second is how much time are you able to invest in your partner relationship or couple time. And the third is your family time. And these are all equally really important. And mostly what I have noticed is people seem to compromise on their individual time and devote it to couple and family. The way you prioritize your time might be an indicator of also things that you are going through and how you're trying to either avoid things or overcompensating and spending more time. And so the way we divide time tells a lot about how we're feeling in relationships. So let's start with individual time, or what I call me time. Individual time. So why is individual time so important? Well, who else are you going to spend the most amount of time with? It's yourself. And you need to give it that importance. Me time is so important because that's the time that you get to reflect, do things that you want to do without having to think about what you have to say or where you have to be or what are the responsibilities you need to carry out. It is just peaceful. It's your time to do what you want. And the me time, I ask everyone to spend doing things that you like to do. Listen to good music, maybe have a good glass of coffee, or it could be something where, you know, you're investing your time in doing a hobby. So me time is your time that you spend alone, and you need to feel comfortable with that. And if you feel like, oh, you don't end up getting that me time, you feel extremely depleted of yourself. And if you feel like, oh, I just wish I could be away from everything and just spend some time by myself, that means you're not giving yourself enough time. And I know this is really hard. I know, because if you've noticed over the pandemic, when everyone was under one roof, getting time for just yourself was very hard. You had to run a house or work, look after the kids, look after if you had grandparents or parents staying with you, making sure everyone was safe. There were so many things to be taken care of that the first area that got completely ignored was your individual time. And now with things going back to normalcy a bit, new normal, make sure that you invest that time for yourself. Couple time. Couple time is equally important as individual time. And why is this so important? Because couple time, you have to be able to spend time talking to each other and connecting. You need to be able to do shared experiences together, which is just you and your partner. And third is you got to give time to physically connect as well. So these three are very, very important. Let's break that down a little bit. I won't make it too long, I'll make it short. So the first one is you need time to connect as two individuals, as not just parents and other roles that you need to carry out and talk about all the responsibilities you need to carry out, but just as two individuals. And I call that plug in with your partner. Find out what's going on with them. Did they have a good day? Did they not? How was their week? Anything important? Any good jokes that they heard? It's a place where you start to, you know, just connect as two individuals, not as just husband and wife, but as two individuals who are also friends and want to see how each one's doing. So this is really, really important, because that is when you start to feel connected with your partner. And if you do not spend this time connecting and doing shared experiences, you start to notice that you are going distant with each other. Things are happening in each other's lives that you don't even know is going on. And that's not what you want for a healthy marriage or partnership. So make sure you create some time to connect and plug in. The next one is make sure you go on a date night. If not a date night, some experience that you do together. It could be going for a hike or going for a walk or going for a vacation or a dinner together. The one thing is find something that you both are kind of mutually interested. I have at times couples telling me we both don't have anything in common. That's not true. Find something or do something new to see if that could be something that you both are interested in. Why this is so important is you need to create just time with your spouse or partner to be able to create memories, and this is a way to connect. If you go on a hike and an experience has happened on the hike, I don't know, you find a snake and you both are like, ah, I've seen a snake, one for the first time, one is an expert in snakes. It's an experience that you can think about, go back and laugh about, and you've created a memory, which is very, very important in building a healthy marriage and partnership. The third part, so you have time that you need to spend, shared experiences or a date night, date, evening, afternoon, whatever time. And the third one is connect physically. And this is so, so important, because if you are not having the physical intimacy, then there is going to be a distance that's created between both of you. And it reflects in the way you want to spend time with each other. So if you're physically connected, and this doesn't have to be only about sex, it can be about physical contact in forms of affection and, you know, snuggling together and giving a peck and making sure that the person is felt like they are acknowledged physically in their space and wanted and loved. It creates a lot of connection between the both of you. So this is couple time. And the last one, again, not the least important, is family time. And family time is really, really important, because if you do not spend time with your family, you don't know what is happening in each other's lives. And if you don't know what's really happening in each other's lives, how would you know where you need to come in and support one another? This is a tricky one. It does not mean that I'm asking you to go and find out what, you know, and be invasive in each one's life. It means that when you, you know, make sure that you go and visit your family and siblings and have like once a week family lunch or bi-weekly. It's a place where all of you come, connect, you know that you're a unit, and it becomes very easy that when, you know, things are not going that well, they have an idea that, okay, you know, you lost your job and you're looking for a job, and they, each family member wants to know how you're doing. So having time or setting aside a routine a slot for your family is really helpful for everyone to feel like a family unit and feel the connections for one another and make sure that they're there to support one another. So thank you so much for joining today, and I hope that you can increase your quality time with yourself, with your partner, and with your family. So if you liked what you heard in today's video, please do like, share, and subscribe to MannGhatt. Take care. Bye.